I'll be talking about real-time monitoring GlusterFest. So myself, I'm working in Red Hat Bangalore. I contribute to Gluster GR application, event safety, and other areas. And introduction to GlusterFest, I think Raghavendra Thallur gave a beautiful introduction of the GlusterFest. So I'll not go in detail. So it's a scalable network file system, so which has different configurations like distributed, replication, and different types of volume. So when it is distributed file system, where we try to monitor the stuff, so it is very difficult because multiple nodes and it's not real time. So typically we end up polling the system. So we query the status every often, like frequently we query the system and try to get the status. So wasting a lot of network bandwidth, and it's not real time. Still, it is not real time, even though we poll at 10-second interval or 5-second interval. And some of the status are available through via CLI, but not all the statuses. Like suppose an incident happened in a particular time, we don't know what time it happened. Like if something goes faulty or some node went down, we don't know what time it went down. So let us assume like this is a typical web interface. Maybe like any other, you can consider any other project also, like Overt Engine or Tendril, the new UI is coming. So in this UI, the left side, it's showing the list of volumes and how many bricks are up and all those things. So in the top right corner, you can see it's updated a minute ago. So we don't know the current status. So unless you start polling, get the status of from like query the status, get the status every 10-second interval. So then you can refresh the same UI more real time. But if you do the polling 10-second interval, so you'll end up doing like around 8,000 network calls per day just to get the status. So even though it is not changed, the status is same as previous status, but still you have to do the network call and get the current status. So how Events API is trying to solve this problem is, so there will be one daemon running in all the Gluster nodes called Events D, so which is a which collects the local events and push it to the external monitoring application via webhook. So in this diagram, it's showing like whenever event happens, like say volume is created, it can be user driven events or it can be asynchronous events like a brick going down or split brain is happening or JR application going to faulty. So all the events can be pushed into webhook. So how to enable it? So new daemon is available, which can be started using any of the system service manager. Like in this example, it's showing system CTL. You can use the service Gluster events to start, enable it and start it. So to check the status, it shows the status from all the nodes of the cluster. Like localhost is where we are running this command, and other nodes from the cluster. In this example, there are only two nodes in the cluster. So webhooks, no webhooks are registered yet, so that's why it's showing none. So to register a webhook, so we can. So in this example, it's the 9000. It's listening on the 9000 port and. We can test it. So if we test it, when we run the test command, it shows it's reachable or not from the Gluster nodes. And if it is reachable successfully, then we can add it using a webhook add command. So this is one example of how output, like how webhooks receive, what format it receives. Like in the, when you create a volume called GV1, so it immediately sends the notification to the registered webhook as a in the JSON format as shown in the below. So which includes node ID. Node ID is from where the event is originated, and the timestamp is Unix timestamp, and type of event, like is it volume create, and so we have many other events. And the message is which is specific to the particular event. So in this case, the new volume is created with the name called GV1. So to show an example, so this is a simple prototype which shows list of volumes. So in the below, we say we are seeing the terminal, we are creating the volume, so that is immediately showing in the UI. And other example, So the previous example, the volume create example is user driven event. So user is creating the volume, so that it's somehow easy to track because it is the command. At the end of command, we can add the trigger event. So some of the other events like the brick going down. Here in this example, the brick process is getting killed, so that is immediately reflected in the UI. So we added the event push event in the cluster brick daemon, so that whenever brick goes down, or so even cluster D knows whenever brick goes down, so that can immediately send notification to the webhook. So similarly, one more example to stop the volume, and it immediately shows up in the UI. These are zero replication sessions. There are multiple sessions. Two sessions are running here. So when you stop a zero replication session, the event is immediately cached in the webhook and shown in the UI. So zero replication session again. So whenever a session goes to faulty, or in this example, it is the worker worker PID is killed. So that causes the worker goes to faulty, and it is immediately shown in the UI. So status, as of now, we have around more than 120 events already covered. Splitbrain, volume events, and zero replication, brick events, and many other events we covered, like quota events and all. So there are some requests about filtering the events. So if you register a webhook, now you receive all the events. So but if you are interested only in some kind of, like say, which affects the zero replication session, so we can filter the events like I'm interested only the zero replication event. So we can have a filtering mechanism there. So and now we have the infrastructure ready, and we need to integrate with more external monitoring tools like Nagios, Overt Engine, and many other tools. And other requirement is the web UI to see the notification. All the UI which I showed is just a prototype. So we need a standard UI from the Gluster project, and the email notification which will send. We can set the alerting mechanism, like say if the split brain happening, so immediately notify to admin. So those kind of notification we can set. So all those things are in plan. So we have to get it done. So and the documentation is available in the Gluster Read the Docs website. Yeah, that's all. I think I finished it early. Any questions? Thank you.